Gemcho, that means how are you in the Indian language Gujarati. I understand it fluently, but I don't remember learning it at all. So what the heck happened? Hey guys, what's up? I'm Sapna here for D News. Learning a second language is technically referred to as second language acquisition. That's because acquisition and learning are not quite the same. Acquiring a second language is a subconscious process, but learning a second language is a conscious process based on formal instruction. Both are important. In 1967, linguist and neuroscientist Eric Lennenberg popularized the critical period hypothesis. It's a theory that proposed the best age range to acquire a new language. Lennenberg said the critical period was age 2 to 13. That's around the age you reach puberty. Now, this age range is debated by language experts, and today they prefer to call it the sensitive period instead of the critical period. That's because it's not so critical that you learn a language during that time period only. It's actually never too late. But research shows there are advantages to starting early, and here's why. Kids' brains are way better than adults when it comes to learning because of their plasticity. Their brains are just better at creating new neural pathways. It does that through the creation of new synapses, the connective junctions where one neuron talks to another using electrical and chemical signals. Shortly after birth, synapses form at a rate that's faster than any other time period in our lives. It's known as the exuberant period, where a young brain can create up to 2 million synapses every second. The number of synapses you have peaks between the ages of 4 to 8, but your brain still has a lot of plasticity until puberty. That is why exposure to language at an early age makes such a big difference. Now, although Lennenberg's critical period hypothesis states that the ideal window to acquire a language is age 2 to 13, synapses in the brain's cortex actually start forming much earlier than that, during the second trimester of pregnancy. And there's pretty convincing research that shows language development starts before a baby's even born, so it's probably never too soon for a pregnant mother to speak to her baby. And if you're past puberty, don't worry, it's not too late either. So yeah, kids' brains are more adaptable and better at making new brain connections, but adult brains are better at focusing and better at complex thought processes. In fact, adults are faster at learning a new language. So although kids are better at subconsciously acquiring a new language, adults may be better at conscious, systematic learning. And your brain is not the only thing that matters. There are external factors like who's teaching you the language and are you around native speakers of that language. And there are internal factors like personality. If you're outgoing, you're more likely to practice and not be so afraid to make mistakes. And then there's motivation. If you enjoy learning a language, or if you really want to communicate with a hot new boyfriend or girlfriend, it sounds cheesy, but studies show you'll be more successful. There is a catch to learning a new language as an adult. The research shows you're probably not gonna nail an authentic accent. No matter how hard you try, you're probably gonna sound like a foreigner. But that's okay, because did you know that being bilingual could make you smarter? Trace and Alice explain in this video.
Turns out, those who spoke two languages or more had better cognitive abilities than what was expected based on the intelligence test they took when they were kids. Now, what's interesting is that even the participants who had learned a second language after the age of 18 had way better results.
Do you speak a second language, or a third or a fourth? If so, how'd you learn it? And do you have any advice on what worked and what didn't? Tell us down in the comments section, and don't forget to subscribe to D News. Thanks for watching.